Assalamu alaikum and good evening. You are watching Hamsab TV and I am Muneeb Hamid with the news.
Four missiles land in Mohmand area. Miscreants fired four missiles into the border area of Mohmand agency from across Afghan border on Thursday. According to a security source, unknown miscreants fired missiles at 1:45 p.m. which landed in a deserted area about 1 kilometer from subdivision complex Bahai Dagh in Mamad Kor area of Kewazai Biazai. No loss of life or property was reported in the attack. The security force officials also retaliated with heavy weapons and targeted a suspected location on the Afghanistan side. After the incident, security was tightened and checking at various checkposts increased in the entire agency. Meanwhile, an improvised explosive device planted by unknown miscreants near the residence of Malik Hayat Gul of Masood Adamzai in Safi Tehsil went off early on Thursday morning. Air Marshal Asghar Khan passes away in Islamabad. Air Marshal retired Asghar Khan, the first native commander-in-chief of the Pakistan Air Force, passed away at the age of 96 on Friday morning in Islamabad, a spokesperson of the PAF said in a statement. Khan, who became the youngest head of PAF at the age of 35, passed away after long illness. His funeral prayers will be offered on Saturday in Abbottabad. Air Marshal Asghar Khan headed the PAF diligently and with courage. With his leadership capabilities, he played a vital role in transforming the PAF into a modern air force. Air Marshal Sohail Khan was quoted as saying in PAF's press release, "Air Marshal Khan had good character, great commitment and professional capability." He added, Khan, a former politician and a World War II veteran fighter pilot, was born in Jammu and Kashmir in 1921. He originally served as an officer in the Superior Head Movement with the intent to have Zulfikar Ali Bhutto released from jail. He also served as the president of Pakistan International Airlines. In 1970, Khan founded Tehreek-e-Istiqlal, a secular political party. In 2012, the party was merged with the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf. Supreme Court slaps complete ban on unlicensed mining in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. The apex court has slapped a complete ban on unlicensed mining in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and it directed the mining department to decide all the license-related applications within 15 days. The Supreme Court's three-year judgment, headed by Chief Justice of Pakistan Mia Saqib Nisar and comprising Justice Faisal Arab and Justice Ijazul Ehsan on Thursday, took up to the Suo Moto case against stone crushing and trees chopping on Margla Hills. The KP Chief Secretary and Secretary Mining appeared before the court, which after hearing the respondent slapped a complete ban on unlicensed mining. NAB Chief orders corruption investigations. National Accountability Bureau Chairman retired Justice Javed Iqbal on Thursday ordered investigation into corruption allegedly committed by a Minister of Balochistan and the Health Secretary and a former Inspector General of Police of Sindh. Justice Iqbal directed the Balochistan NAB Director General to verify a complaint against Balochistan Minister for Forest Obadullah Jan Babat for accumulating assets beyond known sources of his income. The accused owns properties in Dubai and Karachi worth ₹130 million, two bungalows in Multan and one bungalow in Quetta, and a petrol pump worth ₹75 million in DG Khan. The NAB chairman ordered investigation against former Inspector General of Police Sindh Ghulam Haider Jamali, Sohail Jamali and others for occupying the Forest Department's 2,500 acres of land. They are also accused of cultivating the agricultural land in Sujavel with connivance of the Revenue Department. The investigation has also been ordered against Sindh Health Secretary Dr. Fazlullah Pechohu for misusing his authority and posting and transferring his favorites in violations of rules and regulations. Musharraf's party approaches court for rally permission in Karachi. All Pakistan Muslim League, the party headed by former military ruler retired General Pervez Musharraf, on Thursday moved the Sindh High Court seeking permission for holding a public gathering at Liaqabad flyover on January 7. APML leaders filed in the High Court a constitutional petition saying that the party planned to hold a public gathering at the Liaqabad flyover but the administration was not willing to permit it. The petitioners said that they had approached the authorities concealed several times for getting the permission to conduct the public meeting, but in vain, as their application was not entertained. Pakistan and Iran defense ministers discuss unrest in region. Pakistani and Iranian defense ministers on Thursday agreed to hold frequent discussions over the evolving situation in the region. The consensus was reached during a telephonic conversation between Defense Minister Khurram Dastagir Khan and his Iranian counterpart, Brigadier General Amir Hatami. Brigadier General Hatami's call to Mr. Dastagir was the first contact between the two ministers since Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa visited Tehran in November, resetting Pakistan-Iran defense ties. General Hatami told Mr. Dastagir that General Bajwa's visit was a turning point in defense ties between the two countries. Many have been counseling greater Pakistan-Iran cooperation in view of the changing regional situation. Zardari says he backs farmers but will not allow usurpation of industrialist rights. Pakistan People's Party co-chairman Asif Ali Zardari has said that though he stands by farmers protesting against sugar mills over cane prices, he will never allow anybody to usurp rights of industrialists. He warned unnecessary protests would not be helpful for protesting farmers and said PPP government hold provided all required facilities to farmers. Still, some of them prefer to agitate and not to listen to the government. Mr. Zardari was speaking at a reception given in his honor by Sayyid Zulfikar Ali Shah at Sayyid Khadim Ali Shah village near here on Thursday. He said that if sugar mills were suffering some loss in buying the cane at official rate, we will talk to them, and if they want to go to Supreme Court, all well and good. If, however, the mill's owners are not capable of running their factories, they should hand them over to him to run them efficiently. Zubaida Apa passes away in Karachi after brief illness. Renowned chef and media personality Zubaida Tariq passed away in Karachi late Thursday night after a brief illness. She is survived by a son and a daughter. Zubaida Tariq, fondly known as Zubaida Apa, was famous for her culinary skills and housekeeping advices, totkas, a household name. She hosted several widely viewed culinary shows and wrote cookbooks. According to Zubaida Apa's family, her funeral prayers and burial will take place after the afternoon prayer on Friday at Sultan Masjid in Defense Housing Authority. Kabul suicide attack death toll soars to 20. Afghan police say the death toll from the previous night's suicide attack in Kabul has jumped to 20, with another 27 policemen wounded. The attack took place in the eastern part of the Afghan capital, where dozens of security officers had congregated to protect a demonstration of shopkeepers that had been held early in the day following the death of a shopkeeper during a police operation targeting alcohol and bootleggers, an unnamed official has said. A suicide attacker blew himself up near the crowd of police and protesters, killing at least 11 people and wounding 25 others, officials said, in the latest deadly violence to bring carnage to the Afghan capital. Trump lashes out at bombshell book after failing to block release. US President Donald Trump lashed out at a bombshell film book that hits the shelves on Friday, dismissing it as full of lies after threats of legal action failed to block its release. Publishers responded to a cease and desist letter by moving forward by 4 days the release of Fire and Fury inside the Trump White House, an expose by author and political muckraker Michael Wolff that quotes key Trump aides expressing serious doubts about his fitness for office. I authorized zero access to White House, actually turned him down many times for author of a phony book. I never spoke to him for the book. Full of lies, misrepresentations and sources that do not exist, Trump tweeted. America suspends entire security aid to Pakistan. The Trump administration announced on Thursday it is suspending its entire security assistance to Pakistan until it proves its commitment to fight all terrorist groups operating in the region. State Department spokesperson Heather Nauert told a news briefing in Washington that the cutoff is not permanent and only affects military assistance. Under the new approach, funds would be allocated to a particular purpose identified with the allocation and would be released only after that target is achieved. The targets identified with the allocation could be strategic as well as issue specific. Qatar allows full ownership for foreign investors. Qatar has approved legislation allowing 100% ownership for foreign investors in most sectors of the economy in a bid to boost non-energy revenues, the government said on Thursday. The move comes at a time of political crisis in the Gulf, with Qatar under an economic and diplomatic boycott of neighboring countries for the past 7 months. It is also an attempt by Qatar, the third largest economy in the Gulf, to secure new revenues to finance a budget deficit due to the slump in oil prices since mid-2014. Overseas investors will be able to fully own businesses in almost all economic sectors, but they are not allowed to purchase real estate or own franchises, according to the Ministry of Economy and Trade. To invest in the banking and insurance sectors, foreigners need to secure a special permit from the government, the law states. Pro-government rallies in Iran as protesters lie low. Iran saw another day of large pro-regime rallies on Thursday after authorities declared the end of deadly unrest and turned attention to addressing the economic concerns that fueled protests. A week after demonstrations broke out, there was a very heavy police presence on the streets of Tehran, journalists said, and no reports of fresh protests overnight. Limited activity on social media suggested unrest in provincial towns was also down. The US said it may look to impose fresh sanctions on Tehran over its crackdown, but Russia warned Washington against interfering in Iran's internal affairs. Blair suggests voters deserve another say on Brexit. Former British Prime Minister Tony Blair told voters on Thursday that time was running out to reverse Brexit, a folly that he said would torpedo Britain's remaining clout and be regretted for generations to come. More than a year and a half since 2016 Brexit vote, the United Kingdom remains deeply divided over the planned EU exit that Prime Minister Theresa May says will take place on March 29, 2019. Both opponents and supporters of Brexit agree that the divorce is Britain's most significant geopolitical move since World War II, though they cast vastly different futures for the $2.5 trillion UK economy and the world's biggest trading bloc. Blair, Labour Prime Minister from 1997 to 2017, said Britain would be poorer and weaker, and he warned that May had solved none of the problems of Northern Ireland's post-Brexit status. North Korea accepts Olympic stock offer, says South Korean official. The meeting on 9 January will focus on finding a way for North Korean athletes to attend the Winter Olympic Games in South Korea in February. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un said this week that sending a delegation to the Games would be a good opportunity to show unity among North Koreans. The meeting is expected to be held at Panmunjom on the border, the so-called peace village in the heavily guarded demilitarized zone, is where the two sides have historically held talks. According to an official from South Korea's presidential office, the meeting's priority will be the Pyeongchang Winter Games. However, he told South Korea's Yonhap news agency that he believed that there would also be discussions related to improving South-North ties after North's participation in the Olympics becomes final. China tightens bond trading rules. China released new rules tightening bond trading regulations on Thursday with a focus on restricting leverage and banning under-the-table deals. The regulations jointly issued by People's Bank of China and China's banking, securities and insurance regulators come as Beijing launches a series of coordinated initiatives across government agencies designed to reduce leverage on the financial system under the new rules. Published on the central bank's website, institutions must sign written deals when conducting bond repurchase or bond forward transactions. Any deals designed to dodge regulatory requirements are to be banned. Now let's have a look at the sports news. Chile Wellington set to test Pakistan in first New Zealand ODI. A fresh covered pitch, a Chile southerly and some well-directed short-pitched bowling look set to provide Pakistan a real welcome to New Zealand on Saturday. One of world cricket's form teams amid a one-day international winning streak of 9, including the memorable ICC Champions Trophy final against India in June, Pakistan's arrival in Wellington coincides with the storm lashing the country. Outdoor training may be stretched for either side on Friday, given the dire forecast, but game day is predicted to clear and buffet the players with freshly southerly winds and a maximum of 18 degrees centigrade. And now the weather update for the next 24 hours. Rain, thunderstorm with snowfall over the hills is expected at isolated places in Gilgit-Baltistan and Kashmir. Dense foggy conditions are likely to prevail over plain areas of Punjab and Upper Sindh during night and morning hours.
That's all for now. For more news and updates, keep watching Hums Up TV. Take care. Please subscribe to Hums Up TV and hit the notification icon on the screen to get the latest updates of our channel. Thank you for watching Hums Up TV.